Did you know that on Mac, you can cycle through applications simply by pressing and holding the Command key and then pressing Tab? When you do that, a list of all your open applications will appear, and then you can click Tab again to select a particular application. So let's say I wanted to move over to Google Chrome, and then I can release the Command key, and I'll move to Google Chrome. To go back to the App Store, I can press and hold Command, press Tab until I'm over the App Store, then release Command. Hi everyone, I'm Anson Alexander, and welcome to the channel. I hope you enjoyed that bonus tip right there, but without further ado, let's get started with my top 5 Mac tips for beginners. The first tip that I have for using Mac is to make use of Spotlight Search. So you can access Spotlight by going to the top right corner of your screen and clicking on the magnifying glass, or alternatively, you could press the Command key and Spacebar key on your keyboard at the same time, and Spotlight will pop up. And Spotlight allows you to search your computer for just about anything. So you could search it for something as simple as, say, the App Store. And you'll notice that when I do that, the App Store is highlighted, and all I have to do is click on Enter, and it will pop right up. It will open up that application for me. I'm just going to press Command and Spacebar to go back into Spotlight, but we could also search for documents if we wanted to as well. So if I just search for Keynote, you'll notice that a whole bunch of my keynotes pop up here, and I could scroll down and look through the one that I want to open. I could obviously be more specific, but this will work for any type of file. And honestly, you can store documents and files and folders and keep it all organized if you want, but I mostly just use Spotlight to find everything. So it doesn't really matter how they're organized because I just come in here and search. So definitely make use of Spotlight. The second tip that I have for Mac beginners is to get comfortable with the Apple menu at the very top left. So it's just this little Apple logo, and when I click on it, you'll notice that we have a number of different options within here. First of all, if you want to ever find out anything about your computer, what type of computer it is, like how much RAM you have and your processing power and all that sort of thing, how much space you have, you can click on the About This Mac option, and it will pop up and tell you everything that you need to know about your computer. Now, at the same time, we also can access our system preferences here from the Apple menu, and I definitely recommend that you go into your system preferences and just look at everything that's available here. You can also look at some other tutorials I have here on the channel. I go into a lot of different Mac settings and preferences, but you might want to look at your display settings, sound settings, energy saver settings, all sorts of things like that. So go ahead and take a look in there. But in addition to that, we can also sleep our computer, restart it, and shut it down from here as well. So this is a great place to be comfortable using. It's kind of like the start menu in Windows, but you don't have all the other things like applications and files and folders. It's just the core things that run your computer and that control it in terms of system preferences. So get comfortable with the Apple menu. The third tip that I have for beginner Mac users is to understand how closing applications works in Mac. So let's go ahead and let's open up Safari here. And you'll notice that I have Safari open. Okay, I'm at my website. Now in Windows, if I had a browser open and I were to go up and hit the X at the top of the browser, it would actually quit out of that application. That application would stop running on my computer. But you'll notice that I still have Safari up here in my menu bar, which means that this application is still running. And if I use that trick I showed you at the beginning where I press the Command key and then Tab, you'll notice that Safari is also listed here. So that means it's still running as well. That's because closing applications works a little bit differently on Mac. So when we actually hit that red X up here, we didn't quit out of Safari. We just closed this window. So to quit out of Safari, we would actually have to go to the Safari menu and click on Quit Safari, or we could press the Command key and the Q key from within Safari to quit right out of it. So sometimes people can get confused, especially when coming from Windows. If you've been closing your applications just by hitting the X, you might not be actually closing your applications at all. And if you look down in your toolbar, any open applications will have a little dot underneath them. So you might have a lot of little dots in your toolbar, and if you actually quit out of those applications completely, your computer speed might actually increase. So that's something to look at, and that's definitely a tip I have for beginners, especially if you're coming from a Windows environment. The fourth tip that I have for Mac beginners is to get used to finding files with Finder. So if you don't want to use Spotlight like I showed you earlier in this video, what I do want you to become comfortable with is using this little guy right here, the smiley face Finder. So you can click on him in the toolbar and it will open up a new Finder window. And Finder is essentially the application that you can use to find all of the stuff on your computer. So here in Finder, you can click on the Applications folder. And here's where you can find all of the applications that you have on your computer. So you can look through here and maybe see some that you might want to use that you didn't know you had. Keep note that there's also this Utilities folder. And if you go in here, you have a bunch of built-in Mac utilities. For example, Bootcamp Assistant will allow you to run Windows on your computer. Disk Utility allows you to diagnose any problems that you're having with your computer. Migration Assistant helps you bring an older version of Mac over to your computer. Terminal allows you to do command line commands on your computer. So this is a very important folder, especially once you start working more in depth on Mac computers. Notice that you can also access your desktop, your documents, and you can create your own shortcuts. I've created some of my own shortcuts over here on the left side. I can access the other drive that's on this computer. So anytime you want to access Finder or you really can't find something on your computer that you're looking for, even if you've tried Spotlight, click on the Finder window and then use the sidebar over here. You can also go up to the Finder menu and you can go to the Go menu. And this has a list of very important places on your computer. So you can always access your downloads from here, documents, desktop. There's a Recents location. So if you've used a file recently that you can't find, that's a great place to find it. So you can see there's a number of different places in here. And to access this Go menu, you just need to be in the Finder application, which you can get to by clicking on your desktop or, as I said earlier, by clicking on the smiley face guy right here in your toolbar. So definitely get used to finding files with Finder. And the last tip that I want to leave you with is how to take a screenshot on macOS. And the reason that I want to show you that is because it's just so beautiful, especially if you've tried taking screenshots on Windows. It's just so clunky on Mac. It just works so well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to take a screenshot of everything. So to do that, you're going to press and hold the Command key, press and hold the Shift key, and then press the 3 key. And you might hear a little sound, and you'll notice that I have a screenshot preview pop up here in the bottom right. If I let this preview close out, it's going to appear here on my desktop. But I could also just click and I could drag this someplace if I wanted to, so I could drag it here to my desktop. And you'll notice that it takes a picture of all three of my screens that I have open, so I can delete these other two. But here's the screenshot that we took, and you'll notice that it was so quick and it came out full screen perfectly. I could go in and edit this and crop it. And just one little added bonus, I'm going to delete this. Command and delete will send things to the trash if you have them selected. But if I press, instead of the Command key, Shift key, and 3 key, instead of that, if I press Command, Shift, and 4, you'll notice I get some crosshairs, and then I can take a screenshot of just what I select, and that will come out the same way. I can drag that wherever I like. And then I could open that up to take a look. So here's the screenshot that I just took. So that is my fifth tip for Mac beginners, is how to take screenshots. It can be a very useful way to save information on your Mac computer. I hope you all found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.